This video is brought to you by Brilliant. Did you know that there's an analog stopwatch hidden inside the clock app? While it might not be life-changing, its cool factor certainly grabbed my interest and made me look for other iPhone tips and tricks that I never knew existed. Here are my top recent discoveries that I should have known earlier, and towards the end of the video, I'll share with you some cool text replacements that will definitely save you tons of time. Warming up with moving things around while holding. Although iOS is a multi-touch platform, I often forget about it, especially the fact that I can hold things and navigate in and out of apps and UI to later drop them. Instead of copying a message to paste to someone else, for example, I can simply hold that message and drop it to the recipient. What I didn't realize is that I can hold and keep adding to the stack of text that I want to paste. To do that, just grab and hold to a text and move it around to detach it, and then use the yoga move to keep adding to the stack. Keep in mind that you can add a message multiple times, even by accident. While on the topic of grabbing and holding, the same principle can be applied to pretty much any other scenario, like in files, for example. Grab a file, move it a bit to detach it, and then keep adding to the pile of things that you want to move around. If you go to photos, you can use the same principle and grab a bunch of photos to move around and place somewhere else. It is important to note that whatever you hold, whether that is a stack of photos, documents, or text, you can place it pretty much anywhere. I can grab a bunch of photos and paste them into a note. Same goes for files, in case I want to embed them into the same note. This comes in very handy if you want to take photos from your Photos app and organize them into a folder in Files, for example. Okay, so whenever I want to copy something, I'm used to tapping and selecting the text to reveal the copy button, or tap and hold on the file, for example, to essentially summon the secondary menu where I can find the copy option. Although I've accidentally seen this before, three-finger tap almost always brings out a quick copy-paste menu that I can use pretty much anywhere. Let's say I am in Safari and I'm selecting, you know, random text that I want to preserve somewhere. I basically have few choices. I can go to Notes or any other word processing app and paste it there by three-finger tap on an empty space and select the paste icon. Alternatively, I can do the same in Files, where if I three-finger tap and click on the paste icon, I witness iOS creating a text document for me that holds my text. Essentially, the three-finger tap menu is something that can be summoned throughout the system, and not only for copying and pasting. There is the cut action and, more importantly, the undo redo icons, which will save you the embarrassing moment of having to shake your iPhone publicly, which kind of reminds me of the Shake Weights ad.
Shake Weight is the flab-busting breakthrough that trims your arms and shapes your shoulders at the same time. You just shake it, back and forth. There's no motor, no batteries, and you get the results you want.
Moving on to another thing I never knew existed, and that is the ability to put someone on hold. You can do that by holding the mute button long enough, and the other party will be placed on hold. Apparently, depending on where you are, the other party might hear a nice song, or in my case, an annoying voice, saying that I've placed them on hold.
The call is put on hold. Please wait.
The experience is similar to answering to the secondary line while on a call, but available on demand. It would have been nice to be able to choose the hold music or message, but this is a carrier feature. Let's spice things a bit. Moving on to something I should have known long time ago. When taking a screenshot for the means of showcasing something, I've always just drawn ugly circles trying to put emphasis on something. The more stylish and professional way to do that is to click on the plus icon on the bottom right and choose magnifier. Now, with the help of the blue dot, I can increase the size of the magnifier while using the green dot to zoom in as far as it's necessary. Pair that with the opacity option and you'll definitely elevate your status amongst your circle. Let me give you an example. In this screenshot, I can zoom in and focus on the subscribe button of my channel, urging you to press it on your side, because why not? I see a lot of people recommending the iPhone scan feature in the Notes app, where you can press on the three dots to scan a document. The way I use it 99% of the time, however, is in the Files app. When dealing with invoices, I find this an invaluable feature in my accounting workflow. In the Files app, I navigate to the folder that I want to store the scan in and click on the three little dots on the top right to summon the menu and select Scan Documents. Once I scan an invoice, for example, I rename it, And then later, I can just email all the files to my accounting agency. This wouldn't be possible if I were to scan everything in the Notes app. As I did in my recent macOS tips video, which I'll link at the end of this one, I will now go over some quick tips that I recently discovered and then move on to some text replacement shortcuts that you should definitely incorporate. Ready? When changing your volume, press the up or down to summon the volume menu and then gently hold and push it out for some more precise volume control. In settings, go to Safari and scroll down to Open Links. Change it from its default state to In Background. This way, as you browse in Safari, you can tap and hold on the link to open it in the background without leaving your current page. This is extremely time-saving when wanting to open a bunch of links for work processes. Just like on a Mac, you can sign PDFs using the synced signatures and annotations. To sign a document, open a PDF, click on the top right pencil icon, then on the bottom right, hit the plus icon and choose your signature. Next is something really cool. Let's say I want to send a file to a friend of mine. Instead of locating that file and then drag and dropping it, summon Spotlight, search for it, and hold to reveal the secondary menu. Press copy and then paste it in Messages or wherever else you desire. Next is a tip that saves a gesture or two. When in the app library or in the sidebar widget page, instead of swiping out, simply tap on an empty space between the UI elements and you'll be back to the homepage. Next, on the calculator app, swipe on the digits to delete one if you've accidentally pressed it. Before we get to the awesome text replacements, one trick, or more like a tip that I personally take full advantage of, is using my iPhone during bursts of free time to improve on my logic skills. Brilliant helps you learn logic in visual, hands-on ways. For example, it turns you into the rational detective that needs to uncover the truth by helping a cute little robot called Marv show Evil Corp that robots are better than humans. I love those names, by the way. By the end of this course, you'll be able to solve complex logic problems in a systematic way, improving on your critical thinking skills that are the basis for mathematical reasoning. Brilliant is an amazing tool for learning STEM interactively, allowing you to do that at your own pace and even on the go. With its vast library of courses, there's always something fun to dive into. Visit brilliant.org/thisisE or follow the first link in the description below, and the first 200 people to upgrade with my link will get 20% off the annual premium subscription. Okay, so let's talk about the most time-saving feature on the iPhone, text replacement. If you don't know how it works, head over to Settings, General, Keyboard, and Text Replacement. In a nutshell, you can create your custom text or symbols or text and symbols to replace a certain text for the sake of having to type it. For example, the most used text replacement when filling out online forms might be your email address. Click on the plus icon to create your shortcut. In the phrase field, type in your email address. Let's say your long email address goes here at yourdomain.com. In the shortcut field, type @@, which will be your shortcut. From now on, whenever you type @@, your super long email will be inserted, saving you precious time. By the way, those shortcuts are synced with your iCloud account, so you can use them throughout your Apple devices. Now think volume or the number of shortcuts that you can create. Here are some of my favorites. @@ for an email. ## for a phone number. Column and bracket for smiley face. Exclamation mark newsletter places an entire sentence that reads, "Feel free to sign up to my newsletter if you want to see more behind the scenes and fun moments from the kitchen." Exclamation mark web helps me answer to people in comments who require something that I've placed on my website, like my wallpapers. Once I type exclamation mark web, it reads, "You can check out my website for that and the link, thisise.tech. You can combine exclamation mark with any word to replace sentences that you often have to write. HHH creates a heart. AAA adds the Apple logo. OMW replaces with on my way. If you're interested to see how I've set up my iPhone home screen, check out my ultimate iPhone screen guide here. If you are a Mac user, my recent tips video might be of interest to you as well. Like and subscribe, and as always, it's been an absolute pleasure. This is E, over and out.